Europe's Jerry Kelly. 64 yesterday. Excellent round of golf.
Coming off the win from last week. One of the simplest golf swings out here. He kind of knows where the holes are located, oh, too.
How about that?
Here's as we watch Jerry Kelly here for birdie.
Got it.
But it feels like it's been here forever. And Steve Stricker, our leader.
Chris DeMarco showing some excellent form. This is the 18th hole, his ninth of the day, of around 23 feet for birdie to get to 6 under, and he drains it. He would go on to make a birdie at number one, his 10th hole, and he stands at 7 under par.
See most of the players this week who've made putts, they've made them with a lot of speed.
A day ago, and now back here live with Bernard Longer at the first.
The simplicity of that golf swing never gets old. And watch the distance control using the backboard there. Right where Colin Montgomery made his birdie from.
Even just his approach into the putts, he missed quite a few putts yesterday, and he could really be climbing that leaderboard. He's got 244 to that front edge of the green.
Oh, what a beautiful shot from Steve Stricker.
Oh. Okay. Left wrist look.
Something that
it's so. Wait.
Sorry.
I know you're so excited to jump in.
Now I got a seatbelt on, though.
It's so simple. There's not a whole lot of movement, just like in his golf swing. There's not a whole lot of rotation. He gets it. It's simple. He starts the ball online with the right speed, and a lot of that has to do with his setup.
Well, you don't need power, right? In a putting stroke, you don't need power. So taking your wrists to try to create angles. Notice the distance control, by the way, is fantastic. That will be for birdie. It's something that Bobby Locke talked about way back in the 40s. The arching of the wrists. We saw it with Horton Smith, won two of the first three Masters. The arching of the lead wrist. It's very important. And you see players that get hands a little bit lower. In fact, this is what I spoke with Darren Clark about yesterday. Hands get a little lower.
Here's Jerry Kelly, and Nicole, that beautiful second shot leaves him a short birdie attempt.
Well, you can even see the contour of the greens there.
For Monty. Here's Chris DeMarco. Boy, it's good to see him playing well, isn't it?
This is the guy that really started the claw grip. And it has revolutionized putting, Joel. Particularly those that struggle with their putting stroke.
Given new life to so many players.
You bet. In every facet, both.
Marco for a birdie at three.
Look how high his left wrist is.
Well, and this is what I'm saying. One of the reasons why the claw to me has been so successful, it helps stabilize the putter face.
Beauty. With a bit of a teach from Rocco Mediate, he pours it in.
Give the guy the recipe.
Of all this new, there's this history of one of the finest institutions and football programs in the country. So it was quite a thrill earlier this week to go check that out. And all the players, by the way, registered right in that locker room. Even Bernard Longer, who throws a dart there at the third. And all the players received a Notre Dame jersey with their name on the back. And this is the par three, Jerry Kelly.
And this flagstick today is located up on that right plateau, only 4 paces over that false front. How does that not go in, Joel?
Oh, are you kidding me?
In their stroke.
Certainly none of that with Stricker. This is the 13th. This is Durant. He's 200 for the championship.
One of the best ball strikers on this tour, and obviously evidenced right there.
Left himself in a perfect position back up the hill. The early walk.
Chris DeMarco to 8 under par. Here's Paul Laurie. Needs a birdie to try to sneak under this cut line, potential cut line. Oh! How about that? And his first U.S. Senior Open, looking to play the weekend.
The Toms.
See if he learned anything from that.
That from 75 yards.
And that's got enough pace on it to come down the hill. Trying to start this round just like he ended yesterday.
And down it goes for David Toms.
Just bordered by the creek on the left. Unlucky, my gosh, that was unlucky.
And Jimenez, you saw that second rattle the flagstick here at the third. This is third shot. Dikembe can't stop them all.
Greens are running in the high 11s on the stent meter. Not real fast.
Latif Goosen here. 207 yards today, some 33 yards shorter than it was yesterday. But you know, there's only been two birdies here today, and he's not making it look hard. Now Goosen here on five just to clean up his tie to skin with Watson. Alongside Tom Kite. Now Tom Watson playing along alongside Goosen here. Wiley old veteran shot his age yesterday, 69. Oh, look at these two shots. Looks like pitching wedges, not hybrids. A moment ago at five, we saw Watson hit his hybrid in here at about 4 feet. Oh, just gets it on there. And see that little graphic?
Down with this group.
With his wind, with wind off the left, he's found the left bunker. Lovely lie, 165. Fresh as the breeze has been all day. This looks pretty good line-wise.
Really good. The sixth, Goosen for birdie.
After that incredible shot out of the left fairway bunker, it's almost like stealing a shot there. Well done.
Just a moment ago on the seventh from just back of the green here, this is Gary Orr. A little pop punch shot. Get there. That's a nice way to make a birdie. Goosen's line. And now this is Tommy Armour's putt for birdie on the ninth to get him to 4 under. Yep, that's his third birdie of the day. Tommy's been battling some injuries this year. Yep, good shot there.
Next success out here.
David Toms birdie putt at 7. Get it there. I think he knew when he hit that it needed to get there. He likes to draw it, so he's challenging this flagstick. Whoa, what a shot. The best shot we've seen today, and what angle, right? And here's Bob Estes' birdie putt on number 11. That was the walk of a miss. He was definitely thinking that was going to go up. David Toms for his birdie on 9. Oh, what a putt by Toms. using the flag stick to help him down the hill there. And really the first player that's kept it above the hole from that side. Easiest hole on the course so far this week. Yep. Good up and down there. Tell you what, you're struggling when you're chipping and you want to try an alternative method. I'm going to go on 13, short par 4, 374. Oof. Pulls the string there.
A moment ago at the 16th, Steve Larrick, short par 3.
Get away with it. Just get lucky.
Begging for it. Begging for it.
That's a enough pace? Get enough pace? Yes. I thought that little fringe behind him was going to affect his stroke, where he'd have to pull it up.
England is seeded 3.
3.
3, yes.
And you found that out all yourself? I'm impressed by you, Chris Strange. How about that party for Toms? Now just 3 back. Dean Goose in second.
Flag stick right in the front left. I think it's a tough hole location to get close. Maybe not. I just feel like, as Brad was talking about earlier, when it's on the front of the green and just on top of the false front.
Watson's second shot here to 15. Beautiful iron shot there for Watson.
Bruce's tee shot's over 300 yards, just 103 left front with Tief. There's a slope to the left of the flag that you can sort of gather the ball with as well.
And if you're just joining us, Tom Kite, the third member, is grouping left after 9. Wasn't playing well, it's going to hurt.
Against the slope.
And that one just over that right side. But still, a great round for Tom Watson, who now will go 17 for 17. Cuts made in this championship.
And 68 pars, by far the easiest hole on the course. Playing almost 4.5 strokes.
Oh,
gets it to go.
I've seen that so often today, just not playing enough. There's more break than the players see.
That miss right there and that par means the final pairing on Saturday will be